Hi everyone,
in today's session we'll see how we can count the number of words in a given string. So this is generally a programming interview question, like if any string is given. For example, on the screen you can see I'm learning Java programming. So if this is a type of a string, and now the problem is we have to count the number of words, or I would say the occurrence of words. So when I say the count or occurrence of any word, so as you can see on the screen, learning is coming two times, so our program should give output for learning as 2 and for Java as 3 and for programming 1, and as you could see the output over here. So that's the intention of the program which we want to write. Now let's think about how we can solve this problem. You are provided this string, and you have to write a Java program which will return the count of, or the number of occurrence of, every word, right? Let's say if I remove this, let's say Java is coming 2 times, and if someone has changed, right, so your program should be dynamic. So now as you can see, the Java word is coming 2 times, and if I save and execute my program, and the output will change, and here now I am getting the Java count as 2. Okay. So this is the brief overview about what exactly the problem is, and now let's come to the solution part of the problem. Well, if this kind of a string is given, so and the interviewer is asking, you have to provide the count. So like we can think of hash map. So in hash map is a kind of collection in Java. So in hash map we can store key value pairs, right? So logically, if we think, so the problem demands word and their count, so key value. So that's the reason hash map has come to my mind, that okay, we can use hash map in this context, because the problem says you have to give the count for the corresponding word. Okay, now we have decided that yes, we will use hash map. Next thing then, logical approach would be like, okay, now if I want to count the number of words, so at least I should, from this string str, I should be able to read individual words, right? I should be able to fetch I should be able to fetch this, right? I should be able to fetch this, which means we want to get every word from this input string, because string str contains the whole sentence, right? But we have to count the word, so we should think of something like, okay, we should fetch individual words from a given sentence or from a given line. Then a very obvious thing which will come to mind is, okay, if it is a string, and if I split this string with a space, I will get an array of a string which will contain this, right? So if I split this with a space, then I will get, because a split method returns array of strings, right? So looking at the problem, two things we have thought. Okay, number one, we will use hash map because the problem says we won't count for the corresponding words, and the second thing, that we will split this string and convert it into an array, and then we will iterate array, right? And then we will use hash map. So this is the basic logical thinking which you will have to apply, and after that we can write the program. So let's dive into the programming. So I have already written the program for it, so let's see how it goes. So it's pretty simple. It's the implementation of the thing which we have discussed so far. So let's go. Okay, we have thought of, okay, we will use hash map. So we declare hashmap in Java using this statement. So map string comma integer map new hashmap string comma integer. So this is the line using which we can declare any map. And as you could see, the type I have mentioned here is string comma integer. So it shows a string will be the correspond these words, and integer will represent their count. Pretty simple, right? Now, and this is the split method I have used to split my input string. So input string is str. I have used str.split with a space. I will get an string array. So this you have to write. Remember, whenever we call split method of a string class, it returns a string array. This could be another interview question, the basic level. All right, so we got this string array, and this is the for loop to iterate array ar. So this is the main part of the whole solution of the given problem. This is the main part, because this is pretty simple that we have declared map, we split. Now we are iterating over the array, and this is the logic which will do the counting part. Let's see. So what exactly I'm doing. So we have a map, and I'm checking if map has key, right? And here I have used not, which means if the map doesn't contain that key, then I am putting that key and corresponding count. For default, I have taken count as 1. So the array at index 0 will contain I, right? Now my map, initially the map is empty, null. So initially I will not be in the, I is not present in the map. So this will become true. Okay, yes, it's not, it doesn't contain I. So it will put into the map. So AR I, it will represent the word, first word, and count 1. In second iteration, this will fetch array at index 1 will contain M. Now my map will check, okay, whether any key M contain in my map. Again, it's not, because M is not available. So again, it will put into my map. Okay, it's not there. Let's put it into the map. And again, the count will be 1. So, and now the next part is, if learning comes, again, it will put in the learning. But if when iterator this for loop reaches this learning word, so it will be at index 0, 1, 2, 3. So when I is equal to 3, so array will contain this word, right? So my map will check, okay, this learning key is available or not. So this time key is available, right? Because from the previous word, I have already created my map. So at this point learning, it will go into the else part, because it already contains, right? So it will go to the else part, and again it will keep the key as learning, but here the default count which was 1. So this time I am incrementing the count. So map.get arri will give me the previous count, and I'm adding it with plus 1, right? So this will increment the count if the key is already present in the map. And so this for loop will iterate over the array, and this is just the so this is the logic. So it will do the part which we want, and below line is just for printing the output. When I say printing the output, it means it will print the map, because in the map, map is the output, right? Because in the map we are storing each word with its count. So using for each loop of Java, we can iterate over the map. This is the way we iterate over the map, like map.keyset. So x represent keys, so the count of word key, and map.get method can be used to get the value from the map. So map contains key value, so key set gives set of keys, and if we use get method, it gives the corresponding value for the given key. So that's how we can solve this problem. Alright, so it's pretty simple. Let me summarize quickly what we have discussed so far. So the problem was, okay, a line or sentence will be given which will contain repeated words, and we have to give the count of every word. So to solve this problem, we have used the hash map and the split method. Using split, we split the given string into an array of a string, and we iterated over the array, and in the map we keep on putting these words as keys, and we are just checking, okay, if already key is present, so put that key, but at the same time its value should be incremented by one. So this is the logic we have used, and at the end we just printed the hash map. So this was the problem, and this was the solution. So that's what I wanted to discuss in this session today, and I hope you understood the solution and also the problem. All right, so that's all for now. Thank you so much.